Hey guys, it's Jay. Welcome back to my channel, where we discuss the popular culture of the 70s, 80s, and 90s. I really wanted to talk about StarBlazers today. Yes, that StarBlazers. Earth is being attacked by the Gamelons, an alien race who uses their planet bombs to destroy the surface of the Earth, which forces most Earthlings down below the planet. Unfortunately, the planet now only has 1 year to live. StarBlazers begins with an epic battle. The remnants of the Earth Defense Force have rendezvoused on Pluto to try and defend against the invading forces of the Gamelon. Captain Avatar and his fleet have decided to make a last stand. They heroically take on the forces of the Gamelons. Unfortunately for them, it doesn't go too well. The entire fleet is wiped out. And finally, Captain Avatar is forced to retreat. However, the Gamelon forces are relentless, and they continue to try and destroy the remainings of the fleet. So, Captain Alex Wildstar decides to do the most heroic thing and sacrifices himself and his crew to allow the last forces to escape. This will continue to haunt Captain Avatar for the rest of the series. There is hope on the horizon, as a messenger has come to relay a message to Earth. The ship crash lands on Mars, and it's here where we meet Derek Wildstar and Mark Venture, two would-be heroes who were stationed on Mars and far away from the battle, which is on Pluto. The ship, which they suspect was a casualty of the Pluto invasion, crash lands near the base. When they find the pilot, they realize she cannot be human at all. She's definitely an alien, although very much humanoid in appearance. To Wildstar, she is gorgeous, and appears as if she's another casualty of war. We find out later that she bears a message specifically for Earth, and this will change the destiny of the Earthlings and the Earth Defense Force. After returning home, Derek Wildstar learns of his brother's demise. It's here where he blames Captain Avatar for his lack of leadership and being able to bring home his brother.
Captain, I am Derek Wildstar.
Then you're
Alex's younger brother.
He was brave. He stayed behind to fight a delaying action. If he hadn't held the enemy back, we wouldn't have made it back to Earth.
You left him behind.
He chose to stay.
Alex was in your command, Captain. You could have ordered him back.
I'm truly sorry, Wildstar.
Although Captain Avatar and Derek Wildstar will have their differences throughout the series, Derek Wildstar will eventually realize that the burden of command is a heavy one, as he too will have to command his own fleet much later on in the series. It's found after analyzing the unit that it's actually a message from a planet called Iskandar. The message is from Queen Starsha of Iskandar. She implores the people of Earth to send one ship, which will be equipped with much more advanced technology, which they have provided plans for in the message. All this to try and help save the planet Earth from the Gamelons. She offers the Cosmos DNA, an incredible power source which will help to revitalize the Earth back to its splendor, as the Earth presently is completely barren and devastated. This is an incredibly difficult decision for the Earth forces, as they have to decide whether or not to equip all of their resources to actually try and create a vessel powerful enough to make the journey all the way to Iskandar and back within 1 year. If they do not make it back in that 1 year, Earth is doomed. And we don't even know if this promise of the DNA is truthful. It's finally decided that they will send their best scientists, young people who can make the journey, and the remnants of the actual Earth Defense Force with this one ship on a secret mission to try and reach Iskandar. Mark Venture and Derek Wildstar are eventually called to a secret meeting with Captain Avatar. It's here where they reveal the secret identity of the ship which will take them to Iskandar. To their surprise, actually, to their entire horror, they realize that the ship is the Yamato. Yes, the same Yamato from World War II.
So, you have come.
Huh?
What?
We're inside the Yamato.
But now it's a space battleship.
Welcome aboard.
They don't realize it yet, but it's been retrofitted and updated with incredible new technology. Unfortunately, the Gamelons have also discovered that this ship seems to be radiating interesting energy, and they attack it. And Captain Avatar is forced to reveal the capabilities of the Argo. I don't want to ruin too much more of the story, as it's a wonderful interplay between the relationships of the crew of the Argo, the actual relationships that they have with different attacking forces of the Gamelon, and in a lot of ways, the kind of relationships they have in dealing with several different times and situations where they have to cooperate with members of the Gamelon. The story itself is quite compelling. And as a child, I really didn't appreciate it as much as I could today. There really was a lot of political intrigue, a lot of things which really as a child you don't sort of understand. Like why people would have prejudices against one another. Why one race would despise another. These things really do come up several times in the series. And for a time, especially for a cartoon series in North America, they really were hard-hitting and much deeper than what most children's animations or cartoons were dealing with at the time. Well guys, that'll about do it for my look back at StarBlazers. Unfortunately, as a child, I really didn't appreciate it. But today, I look back at it and it just really captures my imagination. It has been remade multiple times over the years. And in fact, it's been made into live-action films in Japan. If you have a chance, I do suggest looking for the original DVDs, as well as the sequels and remakes, which you can probably find on Amazon or eBay. Thanks again for watching, guys, and I really hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please leave me a like, as it helps you two to realize that my content is something that you guys are interested in and that you appreciate my work. If you have any comments or suggestions on anime, pop culture, games, collectibles, or anything else you'd like me to review, please leave that in the comment section below. And consider subscribing, as it really does help me out and does help YouTube realize that my channel is actually growing. Well guys, as always, thank you very much for watching. Geek proud. Check out some of the other episodes I've done. You can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter.